children. How are you all? You are all busy with your exams, I suppose. Besides that, you must also listen to the class and write your notes. Yes or no? I think some of you are not doing so because when the school meet, we can understand. Many of you are not able to give any answers, or they are not able to tell anything about the class that they are listening to. Okay, it's not sufficient. You are writing only unit test, term test only, periodic test only. So it is only in very limited things you are writing. But you have to learn, listen to the class. Because we are coming also, you will have the exam afterwards, you will have the class, is not? So you should be able to listen to the classes is sent to you and write the notes. Don't skip it. Am I clear? So you have already completed some lessons, and I last class I was explaining to you the grammar part, what is active voice, passive voice, and then what to learn in order to change active voice into passive voice. I felt there are so many rules which I may not be able to explain everything, but something main thing is you should know the tense. I explained to you the tense, and there are main three tense, that is past tense, present tense, future tense. And in each tense you will have other three more. I will be explaining only two to you. For example, simple present tense, present continuous tense, present perfect tense. Then past continuous, past perfect. Then future continuous, future perfect tense. So you are able to understand when you see a sentence, if you are able to understand in which tense the sentence is, and what is the subject, what is the verb, and what is the object, you will be able to change an active voice into passive voice. I have given you sufficient explanation last class. So you should know how to. So in the last class, I explained to you simple present. I have given a table, a simple present tense, then present continuous, or simple present, future, past, future, and their continuous tense. Simple present. I have given examples, one example. Same example I used for all three forms. Past tense and present tense and future tense. And past continuous, present continuous and future continuous. I have explained the same sentence how they change into active into passive. Today you will learn how a present perfect tense change into active voice. Or how a past perfect tense sentence change into passive voice. Or a future, I will be using the same sentence for in order to explain the whole tenses. Last class I explained you same sentence, that is he draws a picture. That was the sentence I explained you last class. He draws a picture. How will you change that into passive voice? A picture is drawn by him. It is a simple present tense. When it comes to past tense, he drew a picture. Underline drew, the verb is drew. So a picture was drawn by him. So I told you, always in the passive voice, the past participle of the verb is used with the helping verb. Is, was, all these are helping verb, auxiliary verb. How will you change? He will draw. He has not done. He will in the future, after some time, maybe. A picture will be drawn by him. These are the explanation. And the same continuous tense, same sentence I used for continuous tense was also. Present continuous, future continuous, and past continuous. Okay? The same sentence today I am going to use for the Listen children, why is active voice? Subject is given importance in the active voice. See not? And the active voice, object will become the beginning of the sentence in the passive voice. Here, the object is given more preference. A picture has been drawn by him. Has been drawn by him. Present perfect tense. See the clear? You just need to understand how to change active voice to the passive voice. Okay? Has drawn become has been drawn. Drawn is the third form of the verb. Draw, drew, drawn. Third form of the verb is used with the that has been drawn by him. You should understand? Now look at the word. The same sentence you are going to change into past perfect tense. Past perfect tense. Look at the word. He had drawn. He had drawn a picture. He had drawn. Already over sentence back. Had drawn. Okay? And when there is an active voice. A picture had been drawn. Had been drawn. You see, change it. Had been drawn by the that perfectly actually is drawn sentence back. You already finished something. You don't know when. But this option is he has already prepared a picture, they finished drawing the picture. Here it is just now finished. Here sometimes not finished. That's the difference. Okay? Had drawn become had been drawn by him. This is a past perfect tense. This is the same sentences are used for past perfect tense. And how do you change this same sentence? Perfect tense. Future perfect tense. Look at the word. He will draw a picture. Children will, in the future tense, there will not be much changes because action is not done. Will do means you don't know when. Okay? The even if you look in the present simple present tense, you will find the same. He will draw a picture. When? We don't know. So this is a future tense. In the future, sometimes afterwards we will do it. So he will draw a picture, active voice. And when you change future perfect tense, when the sentence changes into passive voice, look at the word. A picture will have been. A picture will have been drawn by him. A picture will have been drawn by him. You see, understand? Today I have seen the whole the three table, that is the simple present tense, continuous tense and perfect tense together in one single table. I will be sending for you so that you will be able to understand. Sylvia, so you will get the whole thing together, but afterwards only one, already two I will be explaining. That is simple present tense and present continuous tense or past continuous. I will get this. I will be explaining to a class only, but you will not get that. So you will get the class. Okay? And but I will be sending the whole table today. So that you will understand it. So that when I take the next class, you will understand this one. Am I clear to you? So listen to the class carefully, children. It's very, very important. Listening is very, very important. And if you don't understand, I told you, you should be always open to ask any questions. When we have a Google Meet, and that time nobody is opening the mouth, just say yes sister, no sister. No, that's not sufficient. We are all small children now. 8th standard children should be able to take care of your own studies. And you should be able to ask questions. So if you know these things, you will be able to do the active voice and the passive voice minimum. There are so many other rules out there which you will learn in the later classes. Maybe in the higher classes or maybe in the house sometime when you come to the school and so on, we will be able to explain. So all these things, it's not there in the button. In order to change an active voice sentence into passive voice or passive voice into active voice, certain things you, especially the grammar part of the tense, you should be thorough with. How to change? You should know what is always past tense, present tense and past participle. Write, wrote, written. So, like that we should be able to know the three forms of the verb. Then add the auxiliary verb and things together like that. That means is the grammar of these things of the changing into past. But there are rules out there that you have to change it. I may not be able to explain to you in this class like this. It's a little longer. Okay? This much is enough for you to understand the exercise that is given to you in your textbook. In order to teach that only, I explain to you this grammar part for you. Is it clear for you? So you should know, as I told you last time, to learn the but it's called the parts of speech. I just explained to you, I'm not going to write anything, you just listen. There are parts of, 8 parts of speeches are there. What is part of parts of speeches? Parts of speeches, for example, you just look at your finger, hand fingers. There are 5 fingers, isn't it? On this hand, 5 fingers are there. Each finger has got its beauty. The shape is, the size is, everything is different.
Thank you.